everyone, welcome back to the Spider's Web. And as you can see from the image in front of you, we are going to be having another video in our Dark Ops terrain or tile sets for Dungeon Saga. Now, what we have in front of us is the, I think, biggest tile. This is the Undead Dwarf King's Throne Room. Now, you can see we've got pieces here that are going to be pillars, or the base of pillars, that will be the pillars. And we have the dais that the throne sits on. And this is made up of, as you can see, hopefully, of five individual pieces. The main piece is at the bottom, and then we have ones of different sizes of lip going up there, and then we have one without the lip, and then we have the one that's slightly smaller that the throne will sit on, that is decorated. It's a simple job to do this. It's not, when I say a simple job, it's time consuming. It takes a little bit of time and a little bit of concentration while you're doing this, but it's well worth it in the end. What you can see here is just like a little design I've done. I know with that the design there is going the opposite way, or right angle to the way these are going. I don't really see it makes any difference, to be brutally honest with you. These are all going one way and this is going another, but that's just, as I said, the way unfortunately it fell. I was looking at that at that angle and just mashed them all up. So as I say, you need a little bit of concentration, but when I realized I was too late, I just carried on doing it this way, and that's what I'm going to be doing from now on. But it doesn't make any difference. I don't think it loses anything at all. So what I will be doing next with this is priming it. Now, like all the other pieces that I'm priming for Dungeon Saga, I'm priming them all in white. And the reason for I'm doing that, this is another set I did white. This one has two squares on the end which have are bisected by a vertical and a horizontal line. And then in here, what looks like a ring that you tie something down to, or could be a trap door or something that you lift up. I don't know exactly what it is. And then this, it's like a metal grill of some description. So what I'm going to do here underneath is do this all reds and yellows, and have this on top, paint this area metal, and all this in the greys and blues like the rest of the areas. Do a little bit of highlighting, kind of thing, stippling with reds on here to make it look as though the heat is coming up and discoloring those parts, so that you come on there and you're standing in the middle there on the heat pad and then getting off as quick as you can. It's one option. After that, I did these three little ones. I think you can see, hopefully, the bisected lines there. This one's got a great big crack running through it. And that's just like an elliptical square with, which is bisected again. So all those four tiles kind of like match. And then just some blank ones, but done one broken. And then a blank one and two with the bisected ones. Anyway. And finally, that I did last night, is these. Now, this is one of the base ones. And again, I did this all white because I'm going to be covering this in yellows and reds. Because the one that goes on top is, as you can see-through. Now, this is supposed to be like a wooden floor, I think. So I'm not sure whether to actually do this. I don't think I'll do this red. I'll do this like a bluish colour, so it looks like it's water. Then again, I may do it completely differently. I may do What's the other colour I could use instead? It's not a paint as such, it's one of the technical paints. Is it Nobles Rot? I can't remember. Let me just check. Yeah, it's technical paint. Nurgle's Rot. I could put that underneath and make it look as though there's like slime and stuff under it. So you can do all sorts of things underneath in these. It could be like a sewage thing going through, which is why I'd do it like a greenish Nurgle's Rot thing. I'll see how it looks. And then using wash over this area to bring out on the grain effects, and then doing the grid grills here, metal. I think it will look absolutely awesome. That's coming up in the next video. What I want to show you in this video is constructing one of the tiles. And the tile I'm thinking of is this tile. So I've punched out all the individual tiles. I was trying to pick them up here. There we are. Here's all the individual tiles and the little pieces as well. There we are. And as you can see, there's designs on some and not on others. And how this is going to go, if you want to make like a Celtic design in the top area here, which we'll have to work out, and then we can design it any way we wish below it. So let's have a look at what we have. That I think is the middle, and then we have that on that side. I'm just guessing at the moment because I'm not 100% sure of how this would work, how this works yet. Even though I had made it up, I'm not trying to think of how I did it. Oh dear. Now what we can do as well is using just a little bit of sandpaper using a little bit of sandpaper going over the edges of these to take off the nubs that's on. So that. Now we need another one there. And we'll run these. Now we have wrong ones. That one doesn't go there. That one goes there. And that one goes there. Because it builds a circle. And then we have that one. And that one. Down the middle. And then we can have that one there. We can put that one there. And we'll have that one in the middle there. And we have missed something, I think. And this, I think I had it set out in a particular way that I'd like it, and I think I've gone and forgotten which way that was. That's not for the, that bit is for that one. And we had perhaps, I cannot remember how I have this set out, but let's try that way. It could be the way I wanted it. No, not at all. Okay. Okay. Okay, what I will try and do then is put that there. No, I'm going to stick with that. So I'll put these ones coming down here. We'll have that one going there, that one going there, that one going there. I think I used another one of those blank ones in another on another sheet, because I changed my mind on something. Okay, so let's have a look. I'm going to take out another one of these. In the ones, and we'll make it look like that. And that's the way that one needs to go. And that one goes that way. There we are. So we want to try and keep all these designs going the same way. And that is how it is going to look. So we'll put that to one side. Now, let me just want to sit here for a second and make sure that I've got everything right where it should be. It looks it. Okay, so now what I want to do is just dry my brush. And I also want to get some sandpaper. For this, I'm using an emery board, and all I'm going to do is one, two on each side, just to shave off and flatten the nub on the end of it. We have to make sure that each of these are going the right way, with this being a set design. So I'm going to put them off to one side for the time being, just while I get to work on this. And it doesn't take all that long, to be honest. So what I'm going to do is just make a start on these and just show you exactly what I'm doing. So we use a little bit of PVA glue on our, I've got an old plastic blister pack from something or other, and a bit of PVA glue. We get that on our brush. Put it on the piece of MDF here, and then place that down like so. And we do the same again on this one. And what I'm trying to do is make it so that it's sort of level and lined up with the edges of the main, but now the base of the tile. Just pop it on, press it down a little bit just to make sure it's sticking. And then we can move over to the next piece. And continuing this way until the entire board is covered. So I'm going to stop now. I'm going to fast forward mode. Oops. And you can listen to some music while I'm doing this. This is the one where it gets a little bit tricky because it's like a few different areas that we need to sort out. And also what you need to also remember is that this is MDF. You don't want to go mad with the sanding, because the dust from MDF isn't terribly pleasant. So just watch what you're doing. Try not to kick it up everywhere, which is why I'm leaving the emery board flat on this board. And then when I finish doing what I'm doing with it, I can just pick the board up and dump it, brush it off in the bin. The last thing I want to be doing is breathing in any of this dust. Not good for you. Not at all. I know what that is. That funny noise then was because this is a damaged piece. It's damaged intentionally. It's to show damage on the tile. It's not actually a damaged piece, but because there's a gap there, that's why it squeaks a little bit. So don't worry about things like that. Just be very careful. And now I have this piece here. There we are, excuse me. And once again, we'll go all across. Oops. Need a bit more glue going on my little blister pack thingy. Just making sure one of these edges, or these two edgy ones, are have enough glue on, well, not just enough glue, but sufficient glue, because the one of these tiles is in three different pieces, and I've got to find out, make sure that I put them in the right place. So that bit goes in there, and then we have that bit that goes like so. I'll do it this way, it might be easier. And then you've got the bits at the top there. Like that. Then we have a piece in the middle, which remembers the bit that has the crack in the tile. And then finally that piece. And that's how you go on with all of these sets. I'm just going to show you with this particular tile how to go about laying them out and using the bases with the tops. Obviously you don't have to do this exactly the same way I am. The edges on that otherwise I look pretty clean, so I'll not bother going over that one. That one just needs a little bit of a touch up here and there. That one doesn't look too bad, and that one's been done, so all I have to do is get some more glue, just a little bit, because we've all got, not got much to do now with this. And there we can go straight across. And so just make sure that the squares are covered in the glue. The lines on these particular things are there just purely so for lining up. They're not there for any detail or any aesthetics or anything. It's just so we can line up and place where it needs to go. That one I want, it's that one. And I'll line that one up with that, so it looks as though whatever it was that broke this tile completely damaged that one as well. And then finally we have this one with the little crack on it. And I like these looking higgledy-piggledy. I don't like them all lined up perfectly. It gives it that look of not so much randomness, but wear. It gives it the look of wear and tear that you would expect to find in a dungeon. Oh dear, there we are. Final two, just a spot more glue if needed. Not much. There we go. I was looking for some glue that dried a little bit quicker than this stuff, but you know, I don't need it, to be honest. I can always do these at night and then leave it overnight to dry. Here we have a penultimate piece going on. And the final piece to go on. There we are. And that is it for that tile. What we're doing now is just put it to one side, allow it to dry, and then we can come along with the spray primers and give it a covering, and then we can concentrate on painting them after that. If need be, can always go around and tidy up the edges if you think they need to be done. I forgot to do this one, so bear with me a second while I adjust. That wasn't the wisest decision I made. Never mind. dollop some. That's, I shouldn't have done that. Did it without really thinking. I'm so used to using faster drying glue. Oh well. Not to worry, I'm just cover this tail again. Pop this one back on. We can wait for it to dry. And when it's dry, we can come along and sand it. So there we are, that's the Celtic cross room done. I hope you've enjoyed this look at how to make up one of the tiles. As I say, there are lots of different layouts for the tiles. There's one here that's just 6x3. Again, it's a plain tile, and all we really need to do with this is just bang some of the individual tiles that you get on it. You don't have to be the fancy ones, they can be the plain ones, or they can be the fancy ones. I think the one I may use on that is this, which has what looks like a bit of a grain going through. I might even just use those down the middle of it, I don't know yet. But we'll see how it looks as it goes on. But that's it for this video. You've seen how to do one of the tiles. I don't really need to go any further and show you how to do the rest of them. What I do need to do is make sure I've got enough glue on these to actually keep the tiles in place, which I didn't have with that one because it's just fallen off. Oh well, not to worry. If any do come off, put some more glue on. Simple. There we are. That's it. So, as I said, I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm going to crack on and get more of these tiles made up. And then in the next video, I will paint this one, I think. Show you how we do the, I'll show you how I'm going to do the paintwork on these. As I've said, I'm going to do them to match the bases of the characters that I've done, which is, so it's going to be greys. So what I'll probably have to do with these, once I've primed them, spray up them in black, and then I can go off with the paints to give them the grey stone look that I choose. But that's it, I'll say, for this video. So until next time, as always, take care, God bless, and bye for now.